Hey everyone, I'm Uday Raj. In the last video, we touched upon all the basics of Figma. If you want to check it out, the link is in the description below. In this video, we will learn all about frames in comparison with artboards, frame styles, and nesting capabilities. Timestamps are added in description so that you can skip or repeat specific topics without hassle. Let's get started. Let's compare artboards versus frames. Artboards are viewports that contain designs. Frames in Figma are like containers and they represent both viewports and design elements like buttons, cards, etc. This offers extra benefits. Benefit number one is that you can contain any type of shape, text, or image inside it. Just like shape, you can also use fill, stroke, and effect styles on it. Benefit number two is you can use frames within a frame. Inception fans will know how powerful this concept is. We simply cannot do that with artboards. Frames have lots of properties. You can change its size, add color, stroke, and effect styles on it. Actually, you can use frames instead of a rectangle. This is an incredible time-saving feature. To demonstrate this, let's create a button in traditional way. We need at least three steps. First, draw a rectangle. Second, add button label on it. And third is to group them together. If we use frames, we can do that in two steps. First, add a button label, and second, to draw a frame around it. That's it. This one step might not sound significant, but frame offers additional benefits like responsive constraints and auto layout, which rectangles and group don't offer. Let's try nested frames feature in detail. Create another frame and add fill color to it. We can preview this frame by using preview options. Using arrows, you can see other frames we created before. To create a nested frame, you can either create a frame inside or draw a bigger frame outside this. Check out the layers panel. These frames are added inside a new frame. The outermost frame is called parent and inner frames are called child frames. Select the child frame once again and hit preview. You should note here that preview always presents the parent frame even when you select a child. This is very useful to preview our designs as per exact viewports matching our target device size. Let's check out another cool frame hack. Frames can act as a rectangular mask. To achieve that, you have to make sure that clip content checkbox on the top right section is selected. Once it's selected, any content out of the edge will not be shown. Sometimes you need to turn off this feature to show areas outside the frame too, like in this example. To make a shadow visible, we need to turn off this feature. Cool, now we can see shadow coming out of the frame. If your content goes out of the frame, you can quickly resize your frame by using resize frame option on the top right panel. This little functionality is real time saver. Clip content feature is extended further by ability to choose scrolling behavior. You can add a scroll to preview that extra content within the frame. This is great for creating realistic designs. Check out the first example. We have a list of movies that is beyond the device frame. Let's wrap a frame around it. Switch to Prototype tab in the Properties panel and head over to Overflow Behavior. Select Horizontal Scrolling and hit Preview. As you can see, now we can scroll through the content in the frame. In this another example, we have a map view. This time, let's select the horizontal and vertical scrolling. Preview the designs. Now we can move around the map. How cool is that? We like it when people recognize us by our name. The same is true for the frames. Naming them helps us organize and identify screens later. You can rename a frame by double-clicking on it. Don't forget to use it. That's it for now. I hope you got all the core concepts about the frame. In the next video, we will see how to use constraints, layout grids, and auto layout to create responsive designs. If you like this video, like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell icon. If you want to know more about specific features or have feedback, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching it. See you in the next one.